In this video, we're going to complete the second page, finishing the Graphing Quadratic Functions worksheet on the CUDA software website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. Now in number 5 and 6, we're going to be looking at equations in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c. And we know that that axis of symmetry for our quadratic equation is x equals negative b over 2a. So in the case of number 5, a is equal to 1, since 1 times x squared is 1x squared, or x squared, and b, if we're adding bx in our equation, then our b is a negative 8 in the case of number 5. So now plugging both of them in to our axis of symmetry formula, both the a and the b, we'll get that x is equal to the opposite of negative 8 over 2 times 1. So that's going to be a positive 8 over 2, which equals 4. So our axis of symmetry is x equals 4. So finding where x equals 4, I'll draw that vertical dashed line to help me when sketching the graph of our quadratic function. Now I know the vertex will lie somewhere on this line. And because my a is positive, I know that my quadratic function will open up like a cup, because that a is positive. So making my xy table, knowing that my vertex happens at x equals 4, I'll plug in 4 for x and solve for y. Then I'll be able to plot my vertex. So 4 squared minus 8 times 4 plus 13 is going to be 16 minus 8 times 4, which is 32, plus 13. 16 minus 32 plus 13 is a negative 3. So when x is 4, y is negative 3. So here is the point of my vertex, which will be a minimum. Now let's plot our next point when x is equal to 5. When x is 5, we'll have 5 squared minus 8 times 5 plus 13. 5 squared is 25, 8 times 5 is 40, and we're still adding 13 to that. 25 minus 40 plus 13 is going to give us a negative 2. So plotting 5, negative 2, and then remember our axis of symmetry from x equals 4 to get to x equals 5, we're adding 1. So if we subtract 1, we'll be at x equals 3, and our y values will be the same because they're going to be reflected over that line of symmetry. So the y value will not change. So if we're at 5, negative 2, going 1 to the left of that line, we'll be at 3, negative 2. Now let's figure out when x equals 6, which will give us the point when x equals 6, since that's 2 away from 4, and it will also give us the point when x is equal to 2, since that's 2 away from 4 in the opposite direction. So we'll have 6 squared minus 8 times 6 plus 13. That's 36 minus 48 plus 13, which is equal to a positive 1. So when x is 6, or when x is 2, y will be a positive 1. Now I will connect those points with a curved line, forming my quadratic function in number 5. Moving on to number 6, my a value is a negative 1. So I know that my graph is going to open down like a frown. So I'm going to have a maximum as my vertex. And b is also negative 8. So using my formula, x equals negative b over 2a, finding that axis of symmetry, the opposite of b is the opposite of negative 8, all over 2 times a, which is 2 times negative 1. So we're going to have positive 8 divided by negative 2, which is going to be a negative 4. So my axis of symmetry is x equals negative 4. So finding when x is 4, I'm just going to put a dashed line that I will use as a reference line. So when x is negative 4, I know I'm going to find my vertex, which will be a maximum, since my parabola opens down. So doing my xyt table, x and then negative x squared minus 8x minus 13, plugging in negative 4 for x, we'll have the opposite of negative 4 squared minus 8 times negative 4 minus 13. Negative 4 squared is a positive 16, so that'll be negative 16, since I'm taking the opposite of that, minus 8 times negative 4, which is a negative 32, but I'll be subtracting the negative 32, so adding 32, and then subtracting 13. Negative 16 plus 32 minus 13 is a positive 3. So my maximum occurs at negative 4, 3. Now let's go to negative 3. The opposite of negative 3 squared minus 8 times negative 3 minus 13. That's the opposite of 9 minus negative 24, or plus a positive 24, minus 13. Negative 9 plus 24 minus 13 equals a positive 2. So when x is negative 3, y is a positive 2. And remembering our axis of symmetry, negative 3 is 1 unit greater than negative 4. Negative 5 is 1 unit less than negative 4. So I'm going to keep that same y value at negative 5. So I'll have negative 5, 2. And lastly, we'll find when x is equivalent to negative 2. That'll be the opposite of negative 2 squared minus 8 times negative 2 minus 13. So that would be the opposite of 4 minus 8 times negative 2 is minus negative 16. So plus 16 minus 13. Negative 4 plus 16 minus 13 is equal to a negative 1. So at negative 2 in the x direction, we're at negative 1 in the y direction. And also at negative 6 in the x direction, we're again at negative 1 in the y direction. So now I'll draw a curve connecting those points, forming my quadratic function in number 6. Let's continue on to number 7. Now in number 7 and 8, we're not in ax squared plus bx plus c form. Another form you can write a quadratic in, the function of x or y is equal to a times x minus h squared plus k, where the vertex is equal to h k. So having our function in this form is easier to find the vertex because it's within the formula. So we don't have to find that axis of symmetry and plug that x value in to solve for k. The vertex is in the formula itself. So our a is going to be a positive 1 because 1 times x minus 3 squared is x minus 3 squared. So if our a is a positive 1, we know that our parabola is going to open up. So our vertex is going to be a minimum. However, remember that the vertex will fall on the axis of symmetry. We can still use that vertical line that intersects that vertex as a reflection line. So looking at number 7, a is 1, h is equal to 3, and k is a positive 1. So our vertex of hk is 3, 1. So plotting 3, 1, we'll go over 3 in the x and 1 in the y direction. Now let's use a t-table and plug in other values. So x, and then x minus 3 squared plus 1. Now that we've solved for 3, let's solve for when x is equal to 4. That's 4 minus 3 squared plus 1. 4 minus 3 is 1, so 1 squared plus 1, which is equal to 2, since 1 squared is 1 and 1 plus 1 is 2. So when x is 4, y is equal to 2. However, remember that vertex lies on the axis of symmetry, so we can reflect that point across that line to the point 2, 2. So let's plot one more point and then reflect that as well. Let's look at when x is equal to 5. That will be 5 minus 3 squared plus 1. 5 minus 3 is 2, so 2 squared plus 1 is equal to 4 plus 1, which is 5. So at 5 in the x, we're at 5 in the y. And notice that that 5 in the x is 2 over from that axis of symmetry. So we'll go 2 over to the other side to x equals 1. And x equals 1, we'll have a value of 5 for y. So now I have enough points to draw a curve and connect. And there's my quadratic function in number 7. In number 8, we're in that same format. A times x minus h squared plus k. So a is 1/2, and it's positive, so we know that we're going to have a parabola opening up. So our vertex is going to be a minimum. And remember, the vertex is h, k. So h, in this case, is a positive 4. Since h in the formula is subtracted, this 4 is subtracted, so h is the positive 4. And k is going to be a negative 2, because k is added in the formula, and here our 2 is subtracted, so that's the same as adding a negative. So k is negative 2. So now, plotting our vertex, 4, negative 2, we also have that our axis of symmetry is x equals 4, because the vertex falls on the axis of symmetry. Now let's make a t-table and plot a few more points. So let's see when x is equal to a positive 5. So that's 1/2 times 5 minus 4 squared minus 2, which is 1/2 times 1 squared minus 2, which is 1/2 minus 2, which is equivalent to negative 3/2. 1/2 minus 4/2, since 2 is equivalent to 4/2, is negative 3/2, which you can think of as negative 1.5. So when we're at 5 in the x, we're at negative 1.5 in the y. And because 5 is adding 1 to that axis of symmetry, if we subtract 1 from that axis of symmetry, and our y value will also be negative 3/2. Now let's look at when x is 6. That'll be 1/2 times 6 minus 4 squared minus 2. So that's 1/2 times 2 squared minus 2, which is 1/2 times 4 minus 2, which equals 2 minus 2, since 1/2 times 4 is 2, and 2 minus 2 is 0. So when we're at 6 in the x direction, we're at 0 in the y direction, and because 4 plus 2 equals 6, when we take away 2 from 4, 4 minus 2 will be at 2 in the x direction, and that will have the same y value of 0. So plotting 2, 0. Now I'll draw my curved line connecting those points and forming my parabola. And that's my solution in number 8. If you haven't done so already, like this video and subscribe to my channel. Also, if you're confused at any part, leave a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. So once again, like, subscribe, and share.